Look at the 12th and the 13th verse. Paul says, "Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who worketh in you both to will and to do of his," amen, "good pleasure." Amen. The origin of our activity, amen, the Bible says, amen, it says, Paul says, "Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out," amen, "your own salvation," amen, "with fear and trembling." In other words, amen, looking at the fact that God has saved us, amen, and the fact that we're, amen, been washed in the blood, amen, of the Lamb of God, the crucified one. We've been saved, amen, by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Our salvation is a precious thing.
Yeah.
Amen. And we need to work out what God has already worked in. Because Paul said that God has begun a good work in you.
Yeah.
Amen. The reason why folks can't live the life is because they're nothing in them.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They ain't got nothing on the inside. That's why they ain't living anything.
Amen.
And Paul is telling the Philippians, amen, to work out your own salvation.
Yeah.
Amen. Work it out. Amen. God works it in, puts it in. You work it out with awe and reverence. Amen. The fact that Almighty God has come, amen, to live on the inside of you.
Jesus.
And the salvation that he's given you. Amen. You work it out.
Yeah.
You work it out in obedience. You work it out. Amen. In prayer. You work it out. Amen. In studying of God's word. You work it out by coming. Amen. To church.
Hallelujah.
Sunday school. Bible study. Witnessing. You work out your salvation.
Hallelujah.
Because God is on the inside of you. He says, "For it is God who worketh in you."
Uh-huh.
God is working. Amen. God's at work in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Amen. See, we have a responsibility. Our responsibility, amen, is to obey God. Our responsibility, amen, is to pray. Our responsibility, amen, is to witness. Our responsibility, amen, is to seek God.
Yes.
And God says, "I'll enable you." Mm-hmm. I'll put a desire on the inside of you to be holy. Amen. And then I'll help you to be holy. I'll put a desire on the inside of you to pray. Amen. And then I'll put within you the ability to pray.
Yes.
It's God working. No, you can't. But God can.
Hallelujah.
You can't. I can't. But God can. And we have to understand this. Amen. That the Christian life, amen, is a life, amen, that's lived through Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus Christ is the only person, amen, that lived, amen, the Christian life. He's the one that we look at.
Hallelujah,
Jesus. As the model, amen, for our faith.
Thank you, Jesus.
He's the one that lived, amen, the Christian life. Amen. And so the life that Jesus lived then, lives now. He lives in us.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Jesus said it this way: "I always do those things that are pleasing to my Father."
Yeah.
Amen. In John, amen, 14, Jesus was getting ready to go away. The disciples, amen, were upset about it. Their heart was broken. Amen. And one of the disciples said, "Lord, show us, amen, the Father, that it suffices us." Amen. And so we'll be satisfied. So we'll be, amen, steadfast in this. Show us the Father.
Hallelujah.
And Jesus says, "If you've seen me, you've seen the Father."
Yeah.
And don't you know that the Father is in me?
Yes.
And I'm in him.
Yes.
Amen. And so the life that Jesus was living, amen, was the life that the Father was living through him.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? Amen. That's why Jesus was able to do everything that he was able to do, was because of the empowerment, amen, of the Father. Father's Spirit on the inside and the life that he lived. He lived, amen, through, amen, the Spirit of his Father. And it's the same way with us. That's why God, amen, puts it on the inside of us. His Spirit. And as we work, amen, towards our salvation. Now I'm not saying the word saved, that's not what I'm saying. Amen, because the Bible says we're saved by grace through faith. Amen, but what God puts in us, the desires that God puts within us, the longings that God put within us. Amen. Amen. We have to work those things out. God will put it in your mind to get up and go to church. Yes. It was in my mind this morning. Was it in your mind this morning? Amen. I could have laid there. I was tired. I could have laid there. Amen. But God put it within me. And it was up to me to say, okay, body.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go.
Amen.
And then when I get to church, so I'm still working it out. Okay, hands. Let's praise.
Amen.
Come on, feet.
Amen.
Come on, tongue.
Amen.
God put it within me, but it was me that was working it out.
Yes.
Jesus.
Amen.
You follow what I'm saying?
Thank you, Lord.
And so Jesus Christ is the origin of our activity, his life in us. Amen. Amen. Because remember, Paul was confident, and I'm confident, and you should be confident that the life of Christ on the inside of you, the work that God began on the inside of you, God will continually,
Jesus,
continually work until he comes.
Amen.
And we can be confident, amen, in this very fact. Paul says, for it is God which worketh in you. Amen. I read a story, amen. A evangelist, amen, by the name of D.L. Moody. This drunk man walked up to him. Amen. I told you the story before. Drunk man walked up to him and said, I know you. Right. You that evangelist, amen, that saved me. And the evangelist said, it must have been me, because I know it wasn't God.
Well.
Because God in you will bring about a change.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
He'll set the captive free. It's the anointing on the inside, amen, that destroys the yoke, undoes the heavy burden, and set the captive free.
Thank you.
God can't, amen. God can't, go with me, amen, to God can, rather. We can't, God can. 2 Corinthians 12, chapter. Amen. And Paul says, for this thing I always thought the Lord thrice. God, get it off me. get it off me. Amen. That it might depart from me. Now listen to what the Lord says. He said unto me, my grace is, amen, sufficient, amen, for thee. For my strength is made perfect, amen, in weakness. And most gladly, therefore, will I, amen, rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ, amen, may rest, amen, upon me. Now, Paul, amen, in this particular passage of Scripture, amen, look at the fact, amen, that he was under attack, amen, by the enemy. Amen, and God, amen, told him that his grace was sufficient. Amen, and for, he says, for my strength, God's strength. Amen. The Bible says, amen, that we ought to be strong in the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. In the power of his might.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, amen, that we, amen, are to look at ourselves and say, I'm weak. Amen. And that God on the inside is stronger, right? For greater is he that's in us than he that's within the world. Amen. The Bible says, for my strength, God's strength, is made perfect. Amen. In weakness. Now look at this. Look at this and grab a hold of this. Amen. Because God on the inside, amen, needs to show forth. Amen. Needs to come forth. The power that's on the inside. Amen. Needs to come forth. But that power won't come forth as long as we rely upon our own strength. That power won't come forth as long as we rely upon our own intellect.
Mm-hmm.
We should not trust in the chariots of Egypt. We should not trust in the wisdom of men, but we should trust in the power of God. But God's strength is not perfected in us until we say, Lord, I can't. But you can. For it is God on the inside. No matter what the problems are, no matter what the troubles are, God said, my grace is sufficient.
Yes.
Whatever you're facing, amen, every day in your life, God's grace is sufficient.
Yes.
He's just waiting for us to say, Lord,
yes,
not my will, but thy will.
Yes.
I release, amen, my hold upon myself. I release my hold upon my destiny, and I give it all to you.
Hallelujah.
And then the Lord says, my strength is perfect now. Amen. Because you realize that you not only can you live, you can't live this Christian life without me on the inside, that you can't be victorious, amen, without me, amen, fighting for you and being the captain of your salvation. And we need to be confident. We got too many arrogant saints.
Jesus.
They act like that they save themselves and they keep themselves.
Jesus.
And baptize their own selves in the Holy Ghost.
Oh,
hallelujah.
But God, amen, is looking for a people, amen, that will say, Lord, I trust you to do everything that you say that you will do.
Amen.
And I believe, amen, that you came. And it's not my strength nor my wisdom, but it's by your power. Ain't that what Zechariah said?
Thank you,
Jesus. Amen. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit. Saith, amen, God. And Paul said, most gladly therefore will I rather glory in my infirmities. Amen. Infirmities, amen, is frailties. What we can't do, our inability to do. That's why the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. All your ways acknowledge him. Amen.